Pretty freaking powerful? Yes, I agree. Hey guys, it's Max from Max Tech, and it's been almost 2 years since Apple last refreshed the iMac lineup. We love our 2017 5K iMac, but as time went on and Intel released new processor after processor, we started feeling like this was the next trash can Mac Pro. Thankfully, Apple didn't disappoint, and we now have a 9th gen 8-core i9 available that's rated up to 5 GHz. Yes, this thing should beat a $5,000 iMac Pro in basically every task. And yes, we do have one ordered. We'll be doing direct comparisons and other tests like benchmarks and gaming with the new Vega 48 graphics, so make sure to subscribe and enable notifications. Now, I do have a few serious concerns, but before I talk about them and dig deeper on the i9 model, I want to touch on the new 21-inch. It used to be a good device for normal use, but with the addition of 6-core CPUs and new graphics, this will be the first time I'll be recommending the smaller iMac for video editing. For $1,499, you get a sharp, bright, and color-accurate 4K display with the same graphics that's in the $2,800 MacBook Pro and a CPU that's practically as fast. At this price, it does of course come with a Fusion Drive and 8 gigs of RAM, so I would suggest upgrading to the base SSD for $100 more, and if you can, 16 gigs of RAM. Have a bit more cash? Then spring for the Vega 20 graphics, and you'll have a powerful iMac rivaling my high-end MacBook that costs $1,000 more. Photo editing instead of video? Then skip the graphics upgrade and go for 32 gigs of RAM instead for a Photoshop and Lightroom powerhouse. As always, we'll leave links in the video description for the models that we recommend. Now on to the 5K. Unfortunately, we didn't get a redesign with slimmer bezels like we wanted, but a benefit of that is still having access to the RAM slots, which will save you some serious cash. The base graphics now have an X attached to them, meaning they are slightly faster than the previous versions. We have 6 cores across the board, but the best bang for the buck is the top $299 tier, since it's the only one getting a 9th gen CPU and comes standard with 580X graphics. As always, I definitely spend the $100 to jump to the SSD. Apple charges a whopping $600 for an additional 24 gigs of RAM, but we're gonna save some cash and buy our own 32GB kit for only $180. It's easy, only takes a few minutes to install, and doesn't void your warranty. In fact, Apple even has a how-to guide on their website. We end up saving $420, and as a bonus, we now have 40 gigs of RAM instead of 32, which is enough for most high-end users. I'll go ahead and leave a link down below to the RAM kit that we bought for our 2019 iMac. So is this impressive? I would say definitely. For $300 less than yesterday, we have an iMac with faster RAM, graphics, and processor. Apple has been recently charging more wherever they can, so it's nice to see a cheaper Mac fast enough for most 4K video editors. So what about that iMac Pro killer? Like I mentioned, Apple has been raising the average sales price on its products, and if you opt for the newly offered i9 and Vega graphics, you'll spend $550 more than the previous top spec 5K iMac. But do I care? No, not really. Most people who buy this configuration can afford it, and the price increase isn't for an average performance bump, but one that should perform better than an iMac Pro. How? Well, our 2017 iMac already performed better in some tasks, but where it really struggled is heavy things like raw video editing because it was limited to 4 cores. We now have an 8-core option, but with faster clock speeds, meaning that not only will it have extra grunt when you're maxing out your CPU, but also for most tasks where you typically don't pin your processor to 100%. The 9th gen architecture is also more efficient, so it'll also be faster per clock than the Xeon and the iMac Pro. Onto the graphics, we have a Vega 48 option, but honestly, I'm not sure how much faster it is compared to the 580X or the Vega 56 in the iMac Pro, but we will find out soon in our full performance comparison videos. I am fairly optimistic though, since it's a much newer chip than the Vega 56 and because the Vega 20 in my MacBook made a big difference in performance and also in improved temps. This brings me to my first serious concern, and that's overheating. Previous 4-core iMacs already throttled, so hopefully we won't have the same issue as with the i9 MacBook Pros. This alone may be a good reason to go for the cooler running Vega graphics. Next is no 10 gigabit Ethernet. Now, this isn't a deal breaker, but since they offer it in the iMac Pro and as an option for the new Mac Mini, I was hoping it would be available for fast access to servers without adapters. And last, Apple did not include the T2 chip. Now, this is odd since it has a lot of benefits and it's included in all of their new devices. I can only guess that they wanted to keep this refresh as simple as possible since they didn't change any of the I/O. Overall, we're really happy with the updates as we really weren't expecting an 8-core in the regular iMac or Vega graphics. If you don't need the very best, you can get great performance for less money than before and even good 4K editing with a 21-inch iMac. As a reminder, we do have links to everything in the description and go ahead and click here if you want to see how this thing performs compared to the 2017 iMac and the iMac Pro. This has been Max with Max Tech, and I'll see you in the next video.